EPC Global Standards, which is the last family standard family of GS1. The basis for these standards, as I say, is the electronic product code. These codes will help us to identify items. That means that it's not very different from the codes that we are currently using, the GS1 codes, like the one you see on the products. It's just that we will add a serialized number that will help to identify an item inside the family products. And sorry. So it doesn't apply just to product, but also to pallets or to locations or to RFID readers. And that's where I come to RFID. That's the other layer of this new set of standards. Before, you were reading barcodes with a scanner, but when you scan products, you have to see the barcode, and it takes time, and it's very difficult to read a barcode. For instance, when we introduced barcodes 20 years ago, I would say, it was very difficult to have a barcode well printed on the products. And in each national member organization of GS1, there are a lot of people dedicated to help companies to implement products. For instance, with barcodes, we help them to print it correctly so that it can be scanned correctly at the checkout, which is very, very difficult. With RFID, we are going to another kind of applications to read the numbers and to read that automatically without saying the chip. Because RFID is radio frequency identification. It means that it's a chip that sends the information through the air, and it's read by a reader and transmitted to an information system. But you can read perhaps hundreds or thousands of articles at the same time in a pallet, or many cases in a pallet, without saying the chips. So you can imagine the time that we will gain, and we will also be able to track and trace products much more frequently than we did before. Because when you wanted to check what was inside a pallet before, you had to open the pallet, and it takes too much time. So you can't do that very frequently. But if you can read it instantaneously with the RFID, then you can multiply the reading points and be sure that everything is okay inside the pallet. The last but perhaps most important layer of these EPC Global Family Standard is the EPC Global Network. Why do we need the network? It's very important to understand that the information we put on the products, whether on barcodes or on inside the chip, is just a number. And this number uniquely identifies a product or a unit or entity. And it works like a key to retrieve information inside the network. So you have to access database to retrieve the information. There is no specific information about the product inside the chip. But as it's a unique number, you will retrieve it on the networks. And with the EPC Global Network, which is based on the internet protocols, you can be sure to retrieve the information that concerns this item. So we think that the EPC Global Network is the only way to have real-time vision about where are the products. And that's probably the only or the most efficient way to track and trace products. I will explain why. Here is a quick overview about what is this network. So we start with basic players like a manufacturer, distribution center, and retailer, but there are all logistic providers in between. Let's take these three places. A manufacturer sends the products. What he will do first, he has a EPCIS, which is a database that is inside its company. It's not information that he will transmit to another place in the network or at another